look you right in the eye when you hear what I've got to say. I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to go one step further than anybody here on this television program expected me to do. Assuming that maybe I paid a bounty to get rid of your kid. Obviously, I've had good reason to do anything I wanted to do. You had a lot of nerve. He has a lot of nerve. The whole state of Texas had a lot of nerve calling him the uncrowned world champion because I wouldn't defend my title. Now you've got as far as to put me, the most gorgeous human being and one of the greatest athletes alive, in a cage match, in the reunion.
Hold it, you moron. Listen to me. If I was anywhere near you right now, I would be right there getting you by the throat. You would no longer be a contender yourself.
Yeah.
Because you wouldn't be there.
Well, let me tell you something, all 6'7" and 280 pounds of you. You got to remember one thing. You want the cage match. The NWA wants the cage match. Your kid wants the cage match. And brother, you look me in the face and I remember that. You put me in a cage and try to take my life away from me.
The only attribute that you have to being world champion is that big, massive tongue. That tongue won't be a factor in that ring. Yeah. Partner, you can leave that in the dressing room. It'll be two physical bodies in that ring. Only one is coming out the champion. And I'm going to end this asinine thing right here and now. My son, Kerry, will be the next world heavyweight champion. So enjoy it while you can.
And let me end this, my side of a one way by saying this. I don't mind bleeding, and I don't mind sweating, and I don't mind paying the price to be where I am. And, but Eric, I'm talking to you, Kerry, and I'm talking to you, Fritz. You wanted the match. Now you accept the consequences, because this is going to stay mine for a long, long time. Woo!
Cut that camera. That's enough of that.